Toontown Beta refers to the first time that Toontown was presented as open to the public for beta testing. There were two beta testing periods, known simply as Beta 1 and Beta 2, in which the public could participate in beta testing the game. A period known as Limited Engagement or Sneak Preview began after Beta 2 and let beta testers play the game at a discounted price, before the official release on June 2nd, 2003. The first time Toontown was released to the public was in August of 2001 and lasted until January 16th, 2002. This was the period known as Beta 1. Early in beta development, playground treasures, the items you use to heal yourself, were actual treasure chests in every playground, and you could see the numerical population of each district in your sticker book. The Toon Talker is the earliest form of speechette and functions very similarly. An image of the Toon Talker in its earliest layout can be seen on the screen. I'm not going to go through all the bug fixes and animation updates, but you can view all of the updates by following a link to the beta release notes in the description. Toontown Beta 1 concluded on January 16, 2002. Though Beta 1 had already finished, the Toontown servers continued to run, and many toons eventually found their way back onto the servers. Remarks were made, people were happy, and Toontown was online. During this time, two in-house beta testers, or in other words, the developers, were online. These toons were blue mice and were spotted running around various locations in the game. Their names were Happy 1 and Happy 2. As you know, numbers are normally prohibited from names now, and this was no different back then. One day after Toontown Beta 1 ended, IGN's RPG Vault posted a brief article in the game, mentioning that the only animals available to choose from at the time were ducks, rabbits, dogs, cats, mice, and donkeys? Unfortunately, no, there were no donkeys, but there were horses. Not only did they post this once, but they also posted a brief article just 6 days earlier about the game, making the same mistake, and they also posted the character gallery article twice. Oh yeah, and did we mention that they had full permission from the developers of Toontown to post these articles? On September 10th, 2002, Beta 2 began. Updates during this period include gag shops, the addition of Toon Headquarters, and the addition of Dodgehog, a trolley game. Dodgehog was a removed trolley game in which toons would run across a level trying to avoid cogs while collecting candy on the level. Also added during Beta 2 was a name generator, and a new and much larger layout of Toontown Central Playground. Fortunately, with this new playground came the ability to jump. On October 21st, 2002, Beta 2 ended, and all accounts created during beta periods were deactivated. It should be noted that while beta periods were completely free, there were many occasions of slip-ups made by the developers that would not be acceptable by today's release Toontown standards. For example, the Toon database was unstable early on, and often resulted in loss of progress and even toons. Some SOS cards were even made to be infinitely usable for testing purposes. These SOS cards were Cogs Always Miss, Toons Always Hit, and Restock Gags up to each toon's limit. Limited engagement began at the end of Beta 2 and continued until the official release of the game. Toons who participated were discounted 40% off their first paid month of Toontown. Updates included all new toon animations, cog invasions, toon platoons and headquarters, and just for fun tasks. One just for fun task was Toon Mask, in which toons could wear masks of other animals in the game. This was later removed. There was also a 100 laugh limit on toons at the time due to the lack of cog HQs, golfing, racing, and fishing. Oh yeah, and butterflies don't cause server to crash now. Good to know. Other things that I like to show off, even though they weren't continually within the beta time standards, are fishing and various toon events. In early fishing, the game would automatically lock onto a fish spot, and the player would only have to reel in at a certain speed to catch the fish, similar to how you would have to press the left and right arrow keys in the trolley game Tug of War to knock your opponent in the water. An image of an early interface can be seen on the screen. As for toon events, I'm going solely on Disney Online Worlds for this section, but many famous toon-inspired games are listed. These include Marathon, better known as the Great Toontown Race, Prince and Princess Race, The Little Old Man Riots, which I'd like to see again someday, and Philibot Day. The image seen on screen happens to be from the original Philibot Day. There's another thing that I'd like to talk about. Colored gloves were never actually made available in the public releases of Toontown Online. Though there have been rumors that toons were able to obtain colored gloves through a glitch, most images showing toons with colored gloves are actual pictures taken by the developers of the game. No matter what their origin or history, colored gloves seem to be that beginning staple of mystery in Toontown. Anyways, that's all for now. If you enjoy these trivia and history videos, check the annotations on screen for some more interesting content. More videos will be coming soon, so subscribe to be notified as soon as the new ones arrive. And as always, thanks for watching.